Hi guys, welcome back to my project. This is Eric. The project I made this time is the GPS speedometer application. Please look at this graphic. Isn't the graphics great? It works based on LVGL. Also, I made the graphic widget with a square line. I'm so grateful to be able to see graphics like this on an MCU based. This project is divided into two videos. This video covers the hardware related parts. And the next one will cover working with the user interface in Skyline and LVGL. As you can see on the screen, this is an application that has two screens. The first page is a speedometer, which tells you your current speed and direction. The second page displays the GPS detail information currently being received from the GPS module. You can additionally know the number of connected satellites, coordinates, and altitude as well. A speedometer is a tool that indicates the speed of the vehicle. A GPS module is required to know the speed information. The GPS module I use here is BNAA0Q. There are two models, the BNAA0 and BNAA0Q on the market. BNAA0Q has a built-in QMC 5883 compass, and BNAA0 has HMC 5883 compass. That's the only difference. It has the same size and all the same specs. Since it has the compass module, you can know the heading degree. This is why I use the GPS module, which includes the compass module. This time, to check the operation of the speedometer, I installed it in my car and then drove it. It displays my vehicle speed properly. It does the speed calculation based on GPS information, so we don't have to worry about its accuracy. From now on, let's dive into the hardware. First, let's take a look at the hardware configuration. Here, it's driven by ESP32S3 and the graphic IC is the AP Parallel Connection with SC7796 UI. This is the wireless tech product WT32S01 Plus. I have covered this device in one of my previous videos, so if you are interested, please check it out. You can find the link below. Above is the BNAA0Q, attached with double-sided tape. Let me show you the wiring on the backside. Hang on. SC01 Plus has a metal connector of 1.25 mm, which can use external IOs. From left to right, there are 5V, ground, GPIO 10, GPIO 11, and so on. I made my own 1.25 mm connector to use this port. Connection with the BNAA0Q is very simple. 5V and ground are basically connected, and data received from the GPS module is transferred through serial communication. RX is connected to GPIO 10, and TX is connected to GPIO 11. Data received from the QMC 5883 is transferred through I2C communication. The SCL clock is connected to GPIO 12, and the SDA data line is connected to GPIO 13. This is a very simple hardware configuration. This is a source code for displaying GPS and compass information as text on the screen. If you are working on a project that doesn't require a user interface like drone, I think this should be okay. These are the libraries I used here. If you have ever used GPS on Arduino, it's Tiny GPS Plus that everyone knows. You can get GPS information very easily. Since the GPS module is connected via serial communication, a serial connection is required. ESP32 has a couple of hardware serial ports, but I ran into trouble, so I used this software serial. It works fine. DF Robots library is used to easily get data from compass module. It's good. The last one is the graphic library that is absolutely necessary to draw and output something to the screen. I use this as I'm a huge fan of Robyon GFX. Arduino GFX is also available. Just modify this code based on the hardware you have. These pins connected to the GPS, these pins connected to the compass, and the GPS communication speed. Please refer to the Robyon GFX page for the graphics. There can be so many combinations that I cannot cover them all here. When the app starts, it initializes the display and compass and starts communicating with the GPS. When GPS information is properly received, it's up on the screen in the style I pre-specified. The compass works independently regardless of receiving information from GPS, so the GPS update part and the degree update part are separate. Also, you can choose the field range, 2G or 8G. I set it to 2G because it says it's the best fit for a linear curve and is capable of sampling up to 200 per second, so I set it to the max. And finally, compass data only displays the heading degree. That's it. This is pretty straightforward. You can find this source code on my GitHub page. If you have a question about this, please leave a message under this video. I'm out of my office to test if the device I made is working properly. Indoors, GPS signals are barely received and compass also behaves very oddly. You can see that GPS information is displayed at the top of the screen and the heading degree at the bottom. In the next project, I will cover the user interface based on this. Please stay tuned.